this year, in 2023, October, IRI and its partner, the Department of Agriculture of the Philippines, will be organizing the sixth installment of the International Rice Congress. It will be hosted Philippine International Convention Center in Manila. And this edition will prove to be the biggest edition that we ever had. After 2-3 years spending time in lockdown, this will be the first opportunity where scientists, traders, private sector parties, non-governmental organizations, policymakers involved in the rice sector will have the opportunity again to meet face to face, live, and discuss the problems and challenges that face us in the rice sector and the rice economy, not only in the Philippines, not only in Asia, but globally. And we will have special attention to Africa, a continent where the importance of rice has been growing tremendously over the last decade. It is opportune that we do this in the Philippines. I would say that after having traveled across the globe for 5 installments, the IRC has finally come home to the Philippines, the host to the International Rice Research Institute. And this year, already last year, the Philippines has launched a large program to strengthen its rice sector, to make a further advancement in food self-sufficiency, food self-security. The theme this year is accelerating the transformation of rice-based food systems from gene to globe. Key here is the word food systems. We will not be focusing only on the production of rice and increasing yield. We will be looking at the whole food system, of which rice is the basis. But we will be looking at food quality, at health and nutrition. We will be looking at diversified rice systems, where farmers grow fish and shrimp and vegetables and trees on the bunch. And we will be looking at how the food produced in that system is marketed, traded, eventually reaches the consumers, and what it means to those who eat rice-based food system produced food to their health and nutrition. Another key word here is transformation and acceleration. We need to accelerate the effectiveness of these systems to deliver not only sufficient food in the next couple of years to come, but nutritious food that indeed will improve our health and nutrition. And the system transformation needs to respond to climate change. We will see increasing droughts and floods. We will be seeing increasing number of typhoons. And we need to be resilient food systems to survive for the next generation to come. And then finally, part of the tagline is from gene to globe. So we will be looking at the smallest components in the rice food system, the genes of the rice plants, but also the genes of other plants and animals in the rice food systems. What can we do with the genes to produce new varieties, new breeds that are more resilient to the changes ahead of us caused by climate change, and again that will lead to improved nutritious quality of rice and the other food systems. Then we will look at the regional level. How do we set up, develop, improve our landscapes? We will look at national levels. How do we ensure food security for our people? In our own country and across border, we will be looking at trade. We will be looking at prices of rice. We will be looking at mechanisms at the global level to ensure that the global population has access to enough affordable, healthy and nutritious rice and other foods produced by the rice-based food system. So hence, we will be looking all the way from the smallest element, the gene, to the globe. I welcome you all to attend the 6th installment of the International Rice Congress in October in Manila this year. On behalf of the International Rice Research Institute, our hosts, Department of Agriculture, and everybody else who will be with us to make this 6th installment a great success. Welcome and see you all in Manila.